What up, everybody? Kevin Hart here. I hope that we have all been safe through this pandemic. I tell you what I do miss, the set of Coldest Balls. I want to welcome you to Coldest Balls, Cold Calls, presented by Old Spice.
So we're going to start this thing with giving you some clues as to who's joining you today.
I'm ready for my clues.
He went to college at Stanford University.
Kurt Rambis.
It's not Kurt Rambis.
Okay.
Known for interceptions.
Went to Stanford. Carl Lewis.
From Compton, California.
Ah! Well, why don't you start off with that? Suge Knight. Suge Knight.
We're gonna bring him in.
All right, wait, right now?
Yep.
I'm ready. I'm about to cold call, baby. Oh! Sherm!
What up?
What up with you, champ?
You know, just another day in paradise.
Before we get into anything, man, first of all, this is my first cold call. Glad that is you. We kicking it off with a bang.
Right.
I see you grew your hair out during quarantine. Good for you, buddy.
You know what I mean? I had time.
Quarantine has been what for you?
I don't think I've ever sat still this long since I was probably in elementary school.
Period, right?
Right.
Has it made you respect your wife and what your wife does on a completely different level?
Oh, no question. I had a tremendous amount of respect because anytime I'd have an off day and then sitting there with the kids just, hey, she's throwing a temper tantrum over here, he's breaking this.
I quit.
You quit?
I quit. I told my wife, I quit. And she's like, what are you talking about? I said, on the kids and you, I quit. I can't do it. And I found a spot. I found a little quiet spot in the house, man, and that's where I go. It's under my desk in my office, and I set up my little iPad under there, and I watch some movies or whatever and chill. But because of my size, they don't know where I'm at.
They just open the door, see you're not in there, and then just think, ah.
I guess they went for a drive. I didn't. I'm under the desk. Richard, excuse me for a second. I gotta pay the bills. What time is it? Time to pay the bills. And I wanna introduce you guys to Old Spice Wilderness with Lavender. Wilderness Anti-Perspirant Deodorant. Yes, it is. And this is freshness from real ingredients. Smells like lavender.
I was worried that you missed a word or two off the note card.
No, I didn't have a note card. That's off the... God! Roxy, get out! I'm on an interview. I'm talking to Sherm.
I don't feel like there's a lot of respect there for you.
Yeah, that's my dog, man. My dog know how to open the doors. My dogs are very smart.
I see that.
Okay? What I've learned is that my IQ has transferred over into everyone in my house. So my dogs, they open the doors and they also use the toilet. My dog goes sit on the toilet right now. Dude, get out, man. I'm on an interview, dude. Get out.
I feel like you transferred too much of the IQ.
This is why I quit, man. I want to talk to you about the NFL for a second, dude. I want to talk to you about your level of greatness. Do you feel like on this side of your career that you still have more amazing years in front of you?
Oh, 100%. The game, as I've gotten older, has gotten easier. You know, so many people come in here with you know, all this high praise. Oh man, this kid can run. He can run with the horses, or he can jump out the gym. He can do all that. But that don't always translate to great football play. The game is played above the shoulders.
You know, you talking like that, it reminds me of when I played football. You know, I was breaking it down to more than just a game played on the grass. It was a game played up here. So the IQ, you know, has to be elite. I don't know if you heard about my injury, but I tore my
Was that in your throwing arm? Was that in your throwing arm?
I gotta look back at the tape.
I would want to know what league was that in. You know what I mean? Was it high school?
That I played
school?
In?
Yeah, that you played.
It was a league in Panama. You haven't been to Panama?
We haven't been there yet.
Crazy, one of the best leagues. If you go to panama.com/football/league, you can you'll see all of the tape.
Yeah, what was the name of that team in Panama? If you don't mind
it was
me
the
asking.
The Panama Jacks. The Panama Jacks.
Exactly.
You know what I like? And at the same time, I have a uncomfortable feeling about as well. When you have to remind people of you being a Stanford graduate and you knowing how to conduct yourself.
That's something, you know, that we can go in on for hours about that. Because it's also the well-spoken conversation. You know, hey, they're so well-spoken. It's like, you can, I can use the same vernacular, same vocabulary as a guy right next to me who doesn't have pigment in the skin, but you don't call him well-spoken because that's the expectation, is he's going to understand the words well. You know what I mean?
Exactly. I've seen it, and I've been, it's bothered me before. It's a highlight and not a expectation, you know?
Exactly.
But I think that you've handled it very, very well. I've been a fan for years, but what I like more than anything is the philanthropy that's matched with the play. Where did the want for change come from?
I think the biggest thing was just being growing up in an environment that you saw it. You know what I mean? You saw the disparity. You saw kids going hungry. You go up to school and you're like, everybody's like, man, these kids don't want to get an education. It's like, well, this kid wants to get an education, but he goes home, his lights is off. They won't buy him school supplies. So what I always wanted to do was, if I ever got the opportunity, I wanted to try my best to help those kids just have an even playing field.
I think when you talk about us and where we come from, you know, we're talking about the inner city. We're talking about being a product of our environment. It's our job to go and enlighten and make people understand there's more out there. And like you said, try to even out that playing field. The education is definitely a spot that should be paid a lot of attention to. My thing is financial literacy.
Right.
It's a real problem, and it's not until we 20 plus that we're trying to figure it out, and we're already behind the eight ball.
Whatever blessings, whatever stuff you're given, it's really to give back and to elevate other people and to go back and say, hey, these people have less. Give them more, you know what I mean? Elevate them. Use your platform to each one teach one, each one raise one, each one help one.
It's our job to break the chain. God, bam, bam, bam. We can see you. We can see you, Bam Bam.
Right.
This is why I don't know why you guys are on this. Okay, here we go. Daryl, we can see you too. Daryl, I'm sorry, Richard. These are my guys, but obviously, as you see, there are no help, and they're going to be just a complete distraction. What is this?
Kind of looks like a guitar, though.
It's not a guitar.
He's about to play it.
Neither one of these guys are experienced with technology, which is where this show is going to fall to complete shit.
Right, right.
Bam, bam. Put the sword down. You know, I don't care. I don't care what you do. Do what you want. I'm sorry, Richard. I'm sorry. I want to talk to you right now. Is Richard Sherman a trash talker?
It just depends on occasion. You know what I mean? It depends on who I'm dealing with, the circumstances, if there's history, you know, all the good stuff.
I got to talk to you about Aaron Andrews. Good friend of mine. That's where I felt like some of your trash talking came out. Talk to me about that interview that you had with Aaron Andrews.
That's my girl. We go way back, like four flights on a Cadillac. But that wasn't really trash talk. Like, sometimes it's just the truth. You know what I mean?
Okay. Okay.
You know, sometimes you just let your truth reign free.
Are you and Crabtree still friends?
Well, you know, it's a complicated, convoluted, you know, a lot of moving parts to the situation that, you know, up and down, around and over there.
Got it.
So, you know, one of those situations where you just let it be everywhere but nowhere. And I ain't never there.
You guys should take your jerseys off and exchange them next time you play. Have you ever went to do that and the person that wanted to exchange jerseys with you isn't that good? And you like, meh.
It's been a time or two somebody asked where I was like, there you go. You got it.
I wonder if you guys can just be honest about that. Like, we're talking about truth. Can you just go, maybe you just take mine? Can you say that?
Just like, I don't want to steal your jersey from somebody who might need it.
No. I'm going to wait for your away joint. This the home one. I'm going to wait till I see you away. I'm going to take that jersey. That's what I'm going to do. That's what I'm going to do.
That's it. So, Kev, now I know, you know, from watching the show that you pride yourself on, you know, knowing, you know, the intricate details of each person that comes on the show.
Absolutely.
Background information. So if I asked you what my middle name was, it wouldn't be like a crazy question for you.
No, not at all. Is that your question?
That's the question. Okay.
Rick Sherman.
My middle name's Kevin. So I thought, you know what I mean, it being so close to a name that you're very familiar with that.
Yeah, I don't know why. I could have swore that your middle name was though. And that when you was growing up, they called you everybody run, here come Sherman.
Who told you that?
This guy named Jamal that you grew up with.
Why do you think I grew up with? That's racist.
Huh?
You just think I grew up with a Jamal?
First of all, Jamal is white.
Ah.
Yeah.
Even, It's even worse.
Yes, it's spelled H-A-M-A-L. Hamal. Oh, God. Bam Bam and Daryl, what are you doing? Why are you writing stuff down? You guys are taking notes right now, aren't you? What are you taking notes for? I say stuff all the time. You don't write shit down that I say. And Daryl, take off the helmet. Nobody's talking to you or signing you from your community college days. So let it go, buddy. Do me a favor, Daryl. Why don't you stand up and go ram your face into the wall? Okay?
But you gotta,
make
you gotta
yourself
helmet.
Useful. Bam Bam, what did you just do? Bam Bam, don't! Stop that. Jack. Okay, I'm sorry. It's un... No, Daryl, I didn't mean it. This.
Okay, I know you know this one. See, this is one I'm not even concerned about. What was my high school GPA?
Your high school GPA?
100%.
78.6.
They don't let you get that high.
What high school did you go to?
Dominguez.
There you go.
It was 4.2, but...
4.2? What's the highest?
You can get close to 4.8 if you're doing it right.
God, you're not the smartest. You're a dummy.
I'm guessing yours is like 4.5, right?
Yep.
That's... Okay.
If you ask me anything right now, 2 plus 2, 4. You know what I mean? Like, I'm locked in.
Or how many fights you lost in high school?
Everybody can't go to Stanford. I'm sorry. I apologize. You wanna know what Stanford did to me? They sent me a letter back saying, can you get the f*** out our face? That's exactly what they did. One of the first times that a school has ever responded with that type of profanity. They said, Sir, please.
With a 4.6?
This is Stanford, man. Before we sign off, man, I don't do this. I never do this. But when I'm in town, man, can I hit you up so I can just come to a game?
Yeah, hit me up.
Me and like 20.
Okay, that's what I was expecting. I thought you was gonna say 30.
If I can come down there, maybe get a jersey, some cleats, go to the crib, eat dinner, whatever you do, that's it. That's all I want.
Because I was gonna let you, you know what I mean? Because the Panama Jacks had sent over your trade papers. And
don't
they were
push the conversation with Panama Jacks, though.
I told my GM to go kind of...
No need. I'll send you some links.
But I was just gonna Google it.
You don't got time to do that. Dude, this has been cold calls. This needs to happen more, man. Let's just talk. Two Stanford graduates.
Yeah. Two of them.
Two S grads.
Yeah, that's the chant.
Stanford, you know.
That's that fight song.
I'll see you at the alumni picnic.
Right, because this is your 26th year.
Time flies, man. Where does it go, right?
Right.
Stay strong through the pandemic.
You too. Stay strong. Give back. Stay black.
Yeah, I know that's right. Hey. All right, man.